cuts, and he's just been entrusted with those gold belts. We had the World Tag Team Champions from the WWC down in Puerto Rico here with us tonight. There's the bell. This match is underway. Hank, let me ask you a question. Are those Tag Team Championships on the line right now?
Yes, they are. You got the 28-time WWC Tag Team Champions, Thunder and Lightning. And what's special about this match is that's the debut in the United States of Thunder and Lightning. They didn't debut at WWE. They didn't debut at WCW or TNA or anybody else. They debuted right here in Cleveland Knights Championship Wrestling. 28-time WWC World's Tag Team Champions are defending the titles right here tonight.
Wow, what a treat that is for all the fans here that are loyal fans of the Cleveland Knights Championship Wrestling here in Lorain, Ohio, right outside of Cleveland.
All right, just to differentiate, the smaller one is Thunder and the taller one is Lightning.
I tell you what, the Stateline, they're not newcomers here to Cleveland Knights Championship Wrestling. We saw them at the Evasion event back in October. Back again, this time, my goodness, they're taking on two towering figures in the ring.
Two legends.
That's right, Mr. Thunder and Lightning.
Well, the team of Stateline pulled a big upset at Invasion. They defeated Wes Briscoe and Jesse Sorensen. That was considered an upset.
Stateline guys, they're pretty big guys themselves, but my goodness, they pale in comparison to this team from Puerto Rico.
We got Damian Angel in there against Thunder. Dave Dawson, the fifth man in the ring. I mean, this is a momentous occasion for these guys to debut in America right here.
Nice teamwork. And the artillery definitely showing the fact that they're veterans, they're multi-time World Tag Team Champions, and they have been in the ring together for many, many years.
Oh, Damian Angel with a big body slam of the Giant Lightning. But he didn't soften him up enough before that elbow drop. I mean, Thunder's a big man, but the Lightning is even bigger. No wonder they've been 28-time tag team champion. You wonder how anybody beat them 27 times to relieve them of the title.
That's right. That's what people don't understand. They see the big number, 28-time world tag team champion. Well, how many years has that been? And every time that they've gained the belt back, they had to have lost it once. So that means they've lost 27 times. That means they are 27-time losers.
It's only a testament to the high caliber of opponents they have in Puerto Rico. Sure, they lost the title 27 times, but they lost it to a who's who of all the great wrestlers from all over the world that toured the Isle of Puerto Rico.
I tell you what, Puerto Rico, if you wrestling fans at home don't know it, Puerto Rico, it's a hotbed for professional wrestling.
And you're seeing why they've been champions. Yeah, they're manipulating their opponents and the referee, moving in and out without any tags, and the referee doesn't know any better. Look at them. These guys are masters at the fake tag here.
I mean, they're employing Jimmy Howerton tactics here, and the fans love it.
That's why they're legends. Thunder and Lightning. All right, Thunder back in there again against Damian Angel.
Now, let me tell you something. I have something in common with these two in the ring. You know, one time my nickname used to be Thunder and Lightning. Hey, gotcha. Yeah. Let me tell you, there's Jimmy Howerton is a young boy playing Little League Baseball. You know, I used to pitch some. I was a pitcher. Yeah. And the batters were so scared of me. And Hudson, one time I walked out to the ring, and as I stepped my foot on the pitcher's mound, yeah, the lightning cracked. Struck.
All right,
that's how I got my nickname.
You see the big guy Sky there with that drop kick. I mean, Eddie Taurus has got to realize he's got to let his man work his way to the corner. He keeps coming in, and his poor partner is taking more and more double teaming and punishment. He just ate a drop kick from this giant named Lightning.
In fact, Hudson, I think they call me Thunder and Lightning before they ever step foot in the wrestling ring. 25, 30 years.
Finally gets an eye gouger. Now he tars it. Now he eats a drop toe hold. Eats some of the mat as a result. Wrist lock there by Thunder.
I mean, what impact from everything this team does of heavy artillery? Even a drop toe hold had some major impact. Yeah.
Well, that cheap shot there from Angel. He set up poor Thunder for, now he's at the disadvantage.
I tell you what, the first 5 minutes of this match was all heavy artillery.
Yeah. But we can't still sell Stateline short. Nobody thought they were going to beat Wes Briscoe and Jesse Sorensen on the last show in October, and they pulled off the upset. So who knows? We got to wait and see. Thunder is being double teamed. All right, Dave Dawson. Okay, you got one of those guys out of there. It's going to take a lot more than that to put these guys away.
Absolutely. They're not 28-time tag team champions for nothing. Because even though they had 27 losses, they still had 28 big victories.
Are a big move right now. They want to be WWC Tag Team Champions.
That's right. They're wanting to center their 28 loss for the titles tonight.
Yeah.
If that's the case, they just need to have their plane tickets bought already to head down to Puerto Rico.
Oh, Stateline wins the title. Thunder and Lightning have to come back to the USA to get their title back.
Oh my goodness, that clothesline looked like something out of JBL's playbook.
That's what I call a clothesline clout. Slipping in the ropes on the rebound. Oh, back drop. Big back body drop. He's killing him one clothesline after the other. A diagonal whip. Lightning charges. He eats an elbow. Eddie Torres now measuring. Oh, a scoop. And a big flying power slam by Lightning. One, two. Damien Angel to the rescue. Now he got off. All four men in the ring now. Heavy Howard, and it's breaking down now.
Well, you were busy calling the match. All kind of excitement. I was just pumping this up on social media.
Oh! A 3D maneuver. Lateral press, hooks the leg. Oh! Damien Angel pulls the ref out of the ring.
That should have been a disqualification. The referee showed a little bit of leeway in this championship match.
I mean, that 3D maneuver, that might have been it, but the referee got knocked down. Referee Dave Dawson's putting up with a lot of crap here. All right, once again, he's knocked down. Oh, he's calling for the bell. Calling for the bell.
That's it. This thing's been thrown out. Hank Hudson, what's the official word?
I'm going to find out.
Well, Hank Hudson taking the belts to ringside. We're trying to figure out exactly what's going on here, but the entire situation, fans, has completely broken down.